Mini episode 1177 of the FDH Lounge is brought to you by Sportsology, delivering unconventional columns and webcasts about sports, TV, music, movies, and more. Follow them on the web at sportsology.com.
The FDH Lounge. You want to schedule your life around it.
A long time ago, on a gloomy, wet Cleveland spring night, two men stand alone amidst the late night drizzle. Their voices echo across the vacant station parking lot as they debate the merits of the great American radio show that have been missing for far too long. On that night, an idea was born. That idea became the FDH Lounge. Welcome to the FDH Lounge.
Hello and welcome to FDH Lounge mini episode 1177, part of our FDH Lounge look back, look ahead series with the 2010s and 2020s. This is our examination of the NFL during those time periods. We've got our top players of the 2010s and top projected players of the 2020s and most important storylines of each decade as well. We start with our top five players of the 2010s. Number five, Russell Wilson. Number four, Aaron Donald. Number three, Aaron Rodgers. Number two, Drew Brees. Number one, Tom Brady. For honorable mention, it's Peyton Manning, Darrell Revis, Richard Sherman, Julio Jones, and J.J. Watt. Here's how we project the 2020s. Number 5, Michael Thomas. Number 4, Joey Bosa. Number 3, Deshaun Watson. Number 2, Lamar Jackson. Number 1, Patrick Mahomes. For honorable mention, it's Nick Chubb, Trevor Lawrence, Quentin Nelson, Saquon Barkley, and Tre'Davious White. Here's our top 5 storylines of the 2010s. In a decade where rivalries came and went, Seattle versus San Francisco produced some of the most memorable moments right up to the decade's final regular season game. Manning versus Brady was still a thing well into the 2010s, but Peyton's change of scenery made it not quite the same in terms of team rivalries. Pittsburgh versus Baltimore may have been the most consistent rivalry in terms of having some meaning, but it was rarely for high stakes. The Seahawks and Niners burned bright against each other, and while the war was interrupted by San Fran's post-Harbaugh slump, it was back on like nothing had ever happened in 2019. Number 4, offenses got more wide open than ever before. Mirroring the three-point explosion in the NBA this decade, teams utilized creative versions of the spread and other explosive scheming like never before. The list of collegiate concepts that the experts said would never work on Sundays sure got a lot slimmer in these 10 years. Number 3, CTE cast a nasty shadow as the league was forced to come to grips with a decades-old failed culture of player care. High-profile player deaths like those of Junior Seau and Dave Duerson forced the crisis in player health to the forefront, leading to what were the first but surely will not be the last efforts by the union and league to come to grips with it. With only one insurance company still willing to shield the league against catastrophic claims, the NFL dangling by that narrow thread is easily the most underreported story in sports. Number 2, in a TV world ever more splintered by competition, including from streaming services, the NFL reigns supreme atop all sports and entertainment competition. It's considered to be the gold standard in DVR-proof programming, and Twitter and other social media enhances the immediacy of big moments by serving as a kind of national instant water cooler in an almost unique manner. Number 1, the Patriots dynasty became the longest running in football history. No team had ever repeated as team of the decade before, and the Pats didn't seem like a good bet to become the first until they started the second big roll of their era in 2014. They've broken the Raiders' record for consecutive championship Sunday appearances that was set in the 1970s, and with that metric augmenting their Super Bowl wins and appearances, the second decade of their dynasty has been stronger than their first. It's been shrouded in ethical clouds at every step of the way, but it can also be said that nobody's done it longer on top than Brady and Belichick. And here's our top five storylines looking ahead to the 2020s. Number 5, the heir to Brady Manning may be Mahomes Jackson, with each bringing their own distinctive style to the rivalry. The former is a big gun who primarily kills you through the air, while the latter utilizes his feet very prominently as well. So while they will first and foremost be battling for the supremacy of their teams, the more successful of the two may have additional success in molding the league in their image. Number 4, will Roger Goodell move on, and if so, what changes will ensue? Rumors are that the commish has an end game in sight, which makes sense because the league is closing in on his execrable goal of turning the NFL into a $25 billion enterprise. And yet, anyone optimistic the league would start putting the fans before the almighty dollar would do well to remember that the same owners whose water he so slavishly carries would be hiring his replacement. Number 3. New swank stadia in L.A. and Las Vegas will be the league's crown jewels. Look out, Jerry World, because the league's newest playgrounds for the richest fans among us will be opening in 2020, and the odds are that the league will cram multiple Super Bowls and other huge events into these palaces. There is some question as to whether the Chargers will ever build a sufficient following for L.A., a task made harder by the fact that everyone knows that the town can't support more than one team, and the forthcoming L.A. to Vegas high-speed rail will transport a lot of football fans out of SoCal on football Sundays, but the NFL will die trying to squeeze every last dime out of these taxpayer-built monuments to excess. Number 2, the next TV contract, which will start in 2022, will be important enough that it will significantly enhance existing broadcast titans and or create instant legitimacy for any of the aforementioned streaming giants if they use it to immediately establish a sports brand like Fox did in 1994. CBS even dropped their valuable SEC football contract just to save more money for the NFL. These implications go even wider to the intersection of technology and entertainment. As we have covered on the show previously, the full-on intersection of TV and the Internet has proceeded slower than many anticipated, and one reason has been the continuing strength of network affiliates as a bulwark against the full-on integration. Having the NFL protects those affiliates and indeed the entire system. Conversely, nothing would legitimize a service like YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Amazon Prime, Netflix, or Hulu as a vital source for live programming like the acquisition of an exclusive NFL package. Number 1. After more than 4 decades, further expansion of the season is likely to come again. The present outline supposedly calls for 17 regular season games, with the added one being at a neutral site, probably in foreign countries most of the time, and an extra bye week extending the postseason into mid-February. Of course, this presupposes that the league's often tense labor situation doesn't result in a shutdown of some sort in 2021. Stay tuned for that one. Thank you for joining us for this mini-episode of the FDH Lounge.